God bless you.
I'm reading from Psalm chapter number 7, verse number 13 in the King James Version.
He had also prepared for him the instruments of death. He ordained his arrow against the persecutors. There are arrows of death. There are instruments of death to deal with untimely death and enjoy longevity. Is to understand the patterns, the ways of untimely death. They are very, very obvious, but many people don't give attention to them. We have said you can't frustrate the devices that you do not know. Okay? So this scripture is saying he has also prepared for him an instrument of death. There are a prepared instrument of death that must be dealt with, because you are the instrument God will use to destroy the instrument of death against yourself and your loved ones. So, instrument number one today, we're going to be taking care of. We're going to start it one after another. The first major instrument that the devil uses so often to bring untimely death is sicknesses and diseases. More people in the past 1.5 years have died of coronavirus and related diseases more than any other system of death. We had countries where in a day, it's in thousands. In fact, sicknesses and diseases has brought untimely death more than witches and wizards. And people are concentrating so much on witches and wizards and living what exactly is an arch enemy. In fact, the first fruit of sin is sicknesses. So when Psalm 103 was explaining the benefit of the death of Jesus, he said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefit." He said, "Who has forgiven you your sin or your iniquities and has healed you from sicknesses." So sicknesses and diseases is one major instrument of death that you must deal with. I'd like to show you from 2 Kings chapter 13, verse number 14. Now, Elisha, you remember Elisha, was falling sick of the sickness, wherefore he died. Oh. And Joash, the king of Israel, came down unto him and wept over his face and said, "Oh, my father, the shepherd of Israel and the husbandman therefore." You remember Elisha, a powerful man of God, but he died of a sickness. In fact, that scripture called it his sickness. Mm-hmm. Now Elisha was falling sick of his sickness. There are sickness perennial, majorly, that at one time or the other, you have a sin in your family or in your life. They've repeated themselves over and over, and you kept receiving treatment. You get yourself treated, because that's the only thing hospital does, is to treat you. And to treat you means they don't cure you. That's why some of those sicknesses come over and over, because sicknesses and diseases are spiritual. They are spiritual. I need you to hear that. That's why the Acts of Apostles chapter number 10, verse number 13 say how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. So sicknesses and diseases are oppression of the devil. No matter how medical science explains it, behind every sickness is a demon. Yeah, you better hear me now. So don't only take treatment. Make sure you cure it. What does that one mean? What it means is that whatever sickness you see around you, either it's a fever, either it's an headache, either it's a high blood pressure or diabetes, whatever it is, when you are taking your treatment, be destroying the spirit behind that sickness. He said, "In my name, they will cast out devils." Behind every sickness is a devil. So when you break the yoke, when you cure, when you destroy the spirit behind a disease or sickness in your body or in your family, you are taking care of the instrument of death, number one. Instrument of death, number one, is sicknesses and diseases. And I want you to look around you today and check what kind of sickness you have tested positive to at one time or the other. And they treated you, but the demon is still in you. The demon is still at work in your body. One of the best people you should lay your hands on is yourself. Lay your hands on your head and cure the spirit of headache, because they are instruments of death. So the instrument, number one, that you must frustrate completely from your body in order to enjoy longevity, is the spirit of sicknesses and diseases. Can I pray with you? Put your hand on wherever your sickness is. I curse from the root that spirit of sickness in your body and in your household. Whatever sickness you have ever tested positive to, I destroy and frustrate every devices of death in your life, in the life of your children, and in the life of your family. In Jesus' name, amen. I'd like you to write it under this video. The name of any sickness you have ever had to deal with. Let me give you an example. Because say malaria, you are destroyed forever in my family. You can mention more than one, two, three sicknesses that you have seen around you and publicly disgrace them as you enjoy longevity. God bless you.